everyone, Carol here at Oak House Journals, and I thought I would turn on the camera today and do a little bit of playing in my Raining Woods journal, and I've chosen the green one to play in today. Not really got an idea of what I want to do other than I've got still got plenty of space in my journal, so I thought I would probably try and use one of these darker green pages for something different. So let me clip my journal open like so. I'm just going to pop it to one side because a few bits and bobs that I've pulled out off to one side. So I've got some labels here. I've got these stamps out, but I'm not actually going to do some stamping on camera today because, as you can see, I've already done some stamping. What I've done is I've stamped them onto sticker paper, so they're handy if I want to use those. But I mean, all the products that I'm using are from my favourite stationery shop, as you know, GiftSmilee. So the link to that shop and the products will be in the description box down below. I'm just showing you what I've lifted out. I've got some washi tape here. This isn't GiftSmilee, sorry. I've got a couple of these gorgeous little vellum and paper image books that they do, and I thought I would try and use those. What else have I got lifted out here? I've got some little transparent stickers. There we go. I've not used these before, so I thought I would try and make use of those. I've lifted out a label. I've also got some vellum, printed vellum here. I love this. Look at this, everybody. Look. They're just so pretty on their own. Some lovely images. So I've lifted out those. I love vellum, as you know, so I might be using those. I don't know yet. I've got some labels. This has been knocking around close to my desk for absolutely ages, so I'm determined to use that today. I've lifted out this piece from my scrap box, and it's a piece of handmade paper with a leaf left on it. This is a scrap that was left over from, I think it was week 12 of the 52 tags handmade challenge, and that was just an end piece of the handmade paper that I used to back my page. I've got a piece of vellum here. This is a vellum envelope, and I've got some packaging. Now, I kept this packaging because it says relive your unforgettable moments with journal. It should be with a journal, but I love that, so I might use that. And then this also was some packaging. So I've got some bits and bobs out, as you can see, and I'm just going to see where it takes me. And I can't tell you how nervous I am now that it's come to the moment where I have to actually do something with all of this lot. But anyway, I'm just going to go for it. But I do want to use this. I'm not going to use the whole of the envelope. I am going to use the front sheet of it. And as I'm playing with it, I'm thinking I've got an idea that I'd like to try with a vellum envelope. But this is way too big. Sorry, I'm just moving my bin a bit closer, because otherwise I'll be throwing everything on the floor, and that will never do, will it? I do have an idea that I'd like to try using a vellum envelope. But as I say, this one is too big. It's a bit crumpled in parts, so this is obviously not the one to try that idea out with. But I will have a go shortly, because if you're like me, once I get an idea in my head, I just want to try it, I just want to play with it. And I don't know why I'm trying to sort that out, because this is the piece that I want. Now, what I want, I think, is, and it's a shame it's creased, but I'm going to go with it. I want a piece, really, that is going to be a nice strip down my page. I'm going to go for straight lines on this one. So I'm just roughly eyeballing what I want. It's less... Right, I am going to go with just eyeballing it, so kind of want round about there. And it really would be a lot better if I actually measured this, but not today. Not today. A little bit smaller. I'm going to go just roughly there. Okay. So I've got a bit of a crease up here, everybody, as you can probably see. So I think I will need to have that at the top and tuck it out of the way. And it's still a bit too long. Let me get a pencil and start doing some marks. Otherwise, we'll be here all day, won't we, at this rate? As you know me, I never work particularly fast, do I? Not when I, not when I get going on these things. I really don't. Okay, so I'm kind of thinking I might end up trimming this down a little bit more, everybody, but for the moment, I'm kind of thinking I fancy something like that. So what have I got here? I'm just lifting out things. I do want to use this handmade paper, and I do want that leaf. So I need that to be, I'm just going to rip across the bottom. Oh, it tears beautifully. It's like butter. It really is. It's so soft. It's a shame I obviously didn't trim it very well when I was doing this, because or doing the other piece where I use this, because I've got a huge chunk out of there. It would be nice if that had been smooth, but c'est la vie. And I've got another chunk out up there. So I know if I use my little pegs. Let's try that. Actually, this page might stay open without that paperclip. Yep, I'm just going to do that. So I'm kind of thinking, do I want that? I quite like that organic rough torn edge. I like meeting it at the top there. What have I got? I've got, not ready to use those. So these are just, they're not stickers, they're just plain labels. You get a variety in a pack, and I'm thinking, I'm going to go for this one at the back here, because it's a little bit more delicate than the one at the front, and I like to try and keep these quite delicate. I'm going to get one of these out. I bought these because I love that top, that curved top, and I will put a brad in the top there, I think. I've only used a couple of these. They're all exactly the same. No, they're not. I'm telling you fibs already. Do you know, I'd completely forgotten that they had, they were different. So you get several of each different style. Ooh, now that puts a whole new kettle of fish. I'm still going to go with the top one. That's why I lifted these out, because I thought I would use the top one. I'm still keeping my... I know you probably think I'm very sad for keeping my little paper band on them, but I like using these things when I'm messing around and journaling. So, okay, let's get going. I'm chattering away here and I'm not really paying much attention. So I'm kind of thinking that... I like this leaf, and I wanted to use the leaf because, you know me, I like things that are have a kind of nature theme to them, especially in this little journal. I just think it lends itself. Now, my first reaction is that this is all getting too wide here. I have got my paper, the torn edge off one side, on against the dark green, which is what I like. And I've tucked my straight edge of my vellum behind it so you can't see it. But it does feel too wide. Then I was thinking I would maybe have that and just put it inside the border on this envelope, or this border here, as you can see, on this envelope, this label. Gosh, brain's gone. And do that. So I'm liking that. Let me just clip that together before I go any further. I always find I need 10 hands. I think I was watching, well, I know I was watching a video that Nick was doing, and she was saying she was using her little clamps for her bookbinding project, and she was saying that you always need a third hand, don't you, when you're crafting. Quite like, actually, I like that a lot, that label there. I'm liking that it's picking up this lighter shade of green from the leaf, and then I've got the dark behind. What else have I got here? Now, I wanted to use that, was desperate to use that, wasn't I? So can I tuck that behind? Really want that 25. That's what I'm trying to get. I like the phases of the moon because that's what it's saying. Is that right? Not sure about that, actually, everybody. Not sure. It's looking a little bit too fussy. Okay. What else did I lift out? So I've got my wrapping papers. This has got some nice... Sorry, I'm hesitating because it's got some very, very fine script on there. And I'm wondering if I could use that on there and just pick up that portion, but tuck it underneath so that you're just getting the hint of it down below. But I think I've got too much going on this page, especially with this long label there. So I think less is more and leave that. So I'm going to put that away. So what else did I have? I had these stickers. Well, they're not stickers, the vellum pieces. And I was wondering whether I could put a little piece on the bottom there. If I hold that up to the camera, you can see how delicate that vellum is. And what I was thinking was I could maybe just rip it and have that on there. Maybe take that 25 out. Oh, I'm liking that. Oh, that's nicer up there. Yeah. That's kind of leaving me with something down here that I need to do something with. Unless I pull that down like that. What's it look like on the other side? Whether we could do that. Come across here maybe. Do you know, I do admire these people that instantly know what's right and can just go with it. Let's see what other images we've got in here. I'm just going to lift this one to one side. I'm liking this yellow one, the first one that I lifted out. The reason being that it's one of my favourite in this pack. It's just very, very delicate. Let's pop that to one side there. The other one is this one. The green is right for this here, but I don't think it's right on this piece, although I am liking how if I ripped, or not ripped, cut down this edge and cut down here, that would be quite a central piece. Because it comes off the end of my page, I think it needs anchoring. And if I anchor it there, then I've got nothing to bring that piece of leaf into the whole spread. And it's, even though it matches this, it's fighting, I think, with these two, because these two are very similar in colour, so not that one. Ooh, just looks nice on there. What else have we got in here? That's too big and bold, I think. Yeah. We've got that one. That's another favourite of mine. Oh, I quite like how that is off the corner, so you kind of get that splash into the page. And then I'd have to think of something up here. I could possibly do some stamping. But then again, it's not tying in that bottom bit very well. Could we do that? Could we lift that up? And here I am going back to my ferns again. Now I have to say, I'm loving that. But again, it's giving me, the colours are better. But it's giving me issues with, I've decorated here, I'm not pulling in that. Unless I bring that lower, then it looks like it's just coming out of a pod or something. Quite liking it up there actually. It's kind of pulling those, it's pulling together that piece and that piece by overlapping. And the stem, I'm picking out that line. But it still is leaving me blank down there. Okay, so I've discounted using that. I know that. Process of elimination here, isn't it, everybody? Okay, so I was thinking of using these and these and perhaps these. So what have we got here? What have we got? Just looking to see whether I could put a stamp on there. What else have we got? Love these little books. You've got vellum, two images per page. And they're all got some blank ones at the back. Some are coloured, some are black and white. But they're lovely. These are really nice. These are very similar, these ones. Oh, I've got some loose ones in here. Oh, that one might do. Ooh, let's lift that one out. These are smaller little images. Oh, that one. Ooh. Sorry. I'm just thinking, ooh, that one might do. Oh, that might be sweet. Ooh. Quite liking that one. And if I pull it down slightly, okay, what's happening here? I'm just trying to explain. What's happening here is that single stem coming down from the hypericum. I'm just I just rested it up on that line there and just let it come down slightly. And by doing that, it's inside this border here. It doesn't come to the bottom here. And I don't know if you can see, but there's some slight text on the bottom. Very, very light, which almost kind of blends into that. It still does leave me with an issue with what to do up there. Because let's try taking, this is where I want my three hands. If I take, yeah, you see that makes it all look too bare up there for me. And I quite like that. Quite like that overlapping outside the border, not quite as much as that. Yeah, I do like that little piece on there, I have to say. Sorry, I got completely sidetracked, didn't I? I was showing you this little book. It's got, again, it's got vellum images. These are more colourful, these images, than in this little one. And it comes in vellum and also in white, or it's like an off-white paper as well. So these are lovely. No black and white ones in that one. So these are both favourites of mine. Now I'm liking that. Let's have a look at that one. Now this is where I'm ending up with too many options now. I'm liking this one as well. I quite like that one. Yeah. This has got deep shades of green, which you're picking up here. But I still have this problem. If this one, as much as I love it, I feel that everything is kind of disparate, everything's separate, nothing's kind of blending. So I'm going to be hard and I'm going to take that one away. I'm still coming back to this one, I have to say. I am liking this one. I think why I'm liking it is because, as I say, it's got that bit of text on the bottom which is blending in. It's just kind of, it just seems to work. I love that this single stem, if I marry it up with this line here on this label and just pull it down a little bit, it takes off that hard edge there. So I'm liking that. I'm loving that it's vellum. I'm loving that I've got some writing here. So the colours are kind of flowing, but it's still leaving me with an issue with what I do up there. And I'm wondering if I do something like that there and then put the stamp as well. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And what I am going to do though is I am going to trim down this piece of vellum. I'm going to put a little brad in, as I plan to do, but I'm going to call that done. So I've just lifted out some of my brads, and really just at a glance I'm looking at what I've got here in terms of colours, and there's nothing really that is going to work with that, I don't think, at all. Now, which one of these is going to go best? I think I will go with the gunmetal. The reason for that is because this border here is a slight grey, even though that is like a fawny coloured. This is more in keeping with gunmetal, so I think I'm going to go with that colour. I'm not going to tighten that up as yet because I'm going to get some thread and wrap around the top of that. So I'll be back in a moment. So this is the one that I've decided to go with, everybody. And so what I'm doing is I'm just tying a little strand of this more delicate twine. I'm just going to open up my brad on the reverse side, give it a good squeeze. And I'm just going to now just trim off these tails. I don't want them too long. I'm just going to go, let me take that piece away. Just going to go with a couple of short pieces. Probably will play with this for hours now, but I'm determined not to. So what I'm doing is I'm just going to get a little bit of glue there. Just pop that in place with a dab of glue, just to hold it where I want it to be, really. Too much of a control freak. So there we go. I'm quite happy with that now. So there we go, everybody. That's my finished piece. Very, very simple. You cannot see any detail at all unless you're really up close of that sticker, doily sticker I put in there. I mean, it is there and you're probably picking up a little bit of a glint where it hits the light. I can see it, but I can't see that you are on the camera. But it's going behind my stamp there. It is adding a little bit of detail, but hardly worth it, I have to say. Lovely stickers. They would probably be better on a solid background, where the delicacy of the doily-like effect would stand out. Here against this background, it's lost, unfortunately. And then I have my little sticker, not sticker, vellum piece at the bottom there. I might just put a dab of glue under that corner. This is going to be famous last words and I'm going to see that dab, aren't I? But I think I just want to secure that little piece down. Nope, that worked. So there we go. That's what that looks like. And I have my layers underneath. So thank you as always, everybody, for watching. I hope you like this piece and Thank you again for watching. Take care. Bye-bye now.